Welcome, beautiful people. Today I will tell you an amazing story. This story is about Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. We, the youth of Triedstone Church, in the very own setting of our own church, will tell you the story about the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Follow me as we go along. Jesus walked in, people waved their palms and welcomed him in with gladness. They heard of the miracles he's done and they hoped and prayed that he would perform one on them too.
Jesus, can you heal me?
Jesus, don't touch her. She's filled with lepers.
By his roots, plant it in the sea, and it will obey you. You can say to a mountain, move from here to there, and it shall move. Nothing will be impossible for you. Greater is he that is in you than he that is of the world. With the power of God, you will be healed, and all your sins will be forgiven.
Fuck me! You tell these people that they can move mountains? They don't hold any power! They are just peasants! You claim you can heal people and forgive sins. I thought only God could do that.
Tell me, what is easy? To teach the word of God and to lead the children of God without knowledge. To be left in the dark and to bring them to the light and truth as my heavenly Father intended. But that you may know, the Son of Man may also forgive sins.
Yeah! Many people did not like Jesus. They thought that what he was doing was wrong. They didn't believe that he was the chosen Messiah. They hated him so much that they believed he operated in witchcraft. Crazy, right? They didn't even know him, but they still hated him. Make sure you pay attention to those priests. They're a big part of our story. But let's continue. Jesus and his disciples are on the way to the Holy Temple. For worship and prayer. Instead, people were exchanging money and bringing sacrifices. He had to cleanse it.
Thank you. that, Jesus?
Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all things happen. It is finished.
What do you mean it is finished? What exactly is finished?
There will be no more need for money trays and animal sacrifices in the temple.
Why, Jesus?
Because I am about to make the ultimate sacrifice. And when I do, that temple shall fall.
As you can see, the priests turned the temple into a horrible place. They profited off of hardworking people and didn't think twice about it. As we see now, the priests had to find some way to get close to Jesus if they wanted to stop him. And the only way to do that was through his friends.
Majesty. What happened at the temple today?
There was this Jew. He came in and destroyed everything. He said we turned the temple to a den of thieves.
Oh, really?
Yes. He also threatened to destroy the temple.
What is this Jew's name?
Jesus! His name is Jesus!
You need to get this Jesus under control because he will not destroy my temple.
Oh, Your Majesty, I've got this under control. I have a plan!
As you just heard, Jesus has to make the ultimate sacrifice. And when he does, that temple will fall. Some people were upset about what he had to say, and they wanted to take him down. Unfortunately, they found a way to do that.
Why did you bring me here?
Be quiet until the priest comes.
Judas, I'm glad you're here.
What do you want from me?
Your friend Jesus. He has gained quite a following. Tell me how he does his works.
He has powers. I can't really explain it.
Powers? Powers to start a trouble, to change money laws, to threaten to destroy the temple, the holiest place in the land? If he was the real Son of God, wouldn't he destroy the temple and disrespect this holy place? The real Son of God will unite the Israelites, not tear them apart.
But what do you want from him?
We just want to talk to him. Judas, we'll grant you 30 pieces of silver. Doesn't that sound nice? A small task for a big reward. So, do we have a deal?
Oh, Judas.
Great. We'll be here for you shortly.
You sold him out. What made you do it? What's it all about? When did it all change? What made you stray? Why the sudden change of heart? What drove you away? As the silver pieces jingle inside your money purse, do you feel any richer? Or do you feel much worse? What were you thinking? Just what have you done? Your friends all trusted you. Now you betrayed everyone. Oh, Judas, what's it all about? Oh, Judas, you sold Jesus out. You're a backstabbing, sneaky, two-faced crook. That's how you'll go down in every history
thank you, Lord, for the meal that you have given us on this day.
Amen.
This is our last meal together before I die.
What do you mean, Jesus?
It's time for you to make the ultimate sacrifice. I'll be betrayed to my enemies. They will arrest me and I'll be sentenced to death. But do not be afraid, for there is no reason to fear. Trust in me and trust in God also. You know where I'm going.
What do you mean? How can we trust you?
I am the way, the truth, and the life. Take this and eat. This is my body. This is my blood. Remember me. Now I must tell you, one of you here will betray me.
Is it I, Jesus?
Is it I, Jesus? Whoever shall take this bread will be the one that betrays me.
No, no. I would never betray you.
Let him go. Some of you will turn away from me tonight.
No, Jesus, we will never turn away from you.
Peter, I tell you the truth. Even you will indeed deny me three times tonight.
I'm doing fine, but you seem upset. What happened with the priest earlier?
Some man named Jesus threatened to destroy my temple.
Jesus? I've heard that name before. My servants talk about him all the time. However, Pilate, there's no reason to get upset. He's probably just another Jew who wants to start problems in the city.
Okay, you're right. Maybe I need to calm down.
Father, I know it must be done. I know it is your will, Father. If it be possible, let this cup pass from me.
Not what I desire, but what you desire. My Father, if this drink cannot come to pass, then let it be so. Amen. Rest later, the hour is ended. Your time has come for me to be betrayed into the hands of sinners. My betrayer is here. Let's go.
The one who receives the kiss is whom we arrest.
Friend, what are you here for?
Him.
Put the sword down, for he that draws the sword will die by the sword. Do you suppose I cannot appeal to my Father and he will really provide me more than enough angels? For all of this has happened in order so that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled.
Jesus, no. Jesus, come back. God, Jesus.
Today I'll make you a gesture of goodwill. You'll be able to release one prisoner, and you will pick. Here are your choices. Barabbas, a murderer, a rapist, and a thief. Or this preacher who claims to be your king and the son of God. You decide their fates. Choose a murderer? Set them free. What about this one?
Get up.
This lawyer can't possibly be our king.
Done. Crucify him.
Help him cross. Jesus had to do it. It was in God's will for it to be done. God loved us so much that he gave his only son to die on the cross for our sins. He made the ultimate sacrifice. However, hope should not be lost because our story isn't over.
How can I be so selfish? How can I be so selfish?
Doubting and believing.
It really is you.
Because as you have seen, you believe. Blessed are those who have not seen, but yet still believe.
God sent his only son to die on the cross for you. God loves you so much that he sent his only son to die for your sins. God wants you to be a part of the body of Christ, and he wants to have a relationship with you. If you do not know who God is and you want to be saved, say this prayer with me.
Father, I confess my sins. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I denounce Satan and his authority in or over my life. God, I pray that you continue to bless my life and continue to direct my path and order my steps. If you said this prayer with me, you are now saved. Welcome to the body of Christ.
Thank you guys so much for watching this YouTube video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to Triedstone Church Chicago YouTube page. Make sure you share this video on all platforms. Share it, post it everywhere. Thank you guys so much for liking. I'm your host, Melody Randall. See you next time.